I am Pam Beebe. I teach here at Kaysville Junior High. I am actually a business and marketing teacher. I don't teach technology and engineering, which is where the 3D printers usually are. So I kind of inherited them and eventually just kind of learned how to use them and started playing around with them a little bit. I'm not great with them, but I know how to do a little bit. It all started with just a single text from my daughter that said, could you 3D print something for me? And she said, I have a friend who wants to 3D print some masks for the first responders. So I went to Provo Police Department's website and downloaded the mask that they were doing. And I contacted Kaysville Police Department and asked if they needed masks.
I'm Officer Lexi Benson. I work for the Kaysville Police Department and I've been there for about 2.5 years. I'm the POP officer, which stands for Problem Oriented Policing Officer, as well as I'm the PIO officer. So I actually got the phone call and my assistant chief actually overheard the phone call and he was all excited. I could see him jumping up and down in the background because I know he's the one that's been going through a lot of the effort to, you know, we have officers that are going out to stores every single day looking for these products and we haven't been able to find them. So it was really huge for our department to have someone willing to just donate these to us at no charge so that we can remain safe.
Hello, my name is Brett Matsumura. I'm the Davis School District CTE Tech and Engineering Specialist. And with our leadership, Superintendent Newey and Jay Wilk, our CTE Director, Davis School District is sponsoring our teachers to print 3D printed PPE for our medical providers and emergency responders upon request. And we have Pam Beebe, who's already started printing. Her work inspired our Director Welk to allow other teachers to participate and support the community during this national health crisis.
I had posted some pictures and video of that on Facebook, and then I start having, you know, I got all kinds of likes and wow, that's really cool. And then I ended up having some people who posted other things on my Facebook page saying, look at this, this is cool. And things like the little headbands, the ear protectors to protect the nurses' ears from having the elastics around them all the time. And so then I have two nieces who are nurses down at University of Utah, and they said, yeah, we could really use those. And then I get an email from one of the teachers here at the school. She had contacted the principal and said, hey, my brother works at Utah State University and they need people to print the headbands for the face shields. Could our printers at our school be used to do that? So I have all these projects that just keep falling into my lap.
So we reached out to our tech and engineering community for the junior highs and high schools and asked on a voluntary basis if they would be willing to help. And we have several different types of printers from very modern styles like the one I'm standing next to older models, 5 years or older. And we want to keep the teachers safe first and then use the school resources to print out these materials. Like everything with the masks that people are making out of materials at home, once the word gets out, and especially if we see an escalation of our incident rate, the demand might grow exponentially.
At the beginning of the school year, Davis School District passed out t-shirts to all of the teachers that said, be the one, and we kind of got an explanation that it was a, you know, be the one to make a difference. And every time I wear that shirt, I think about that, and I think, you know, you just gotta do, it's the little things that make a difference. I can't change the world, but I can change my little piece of the world. I can be the one, I can make a difference to my little piece of the world. So I wanna do what I can for who I can.